Well, hello and welcome to the Terri Cole Show. I am so glad that you are here. If you are new to this crew, my name is Terri Cole and I'm a licensed psychotherapist. I'm a relationship expert and I'm the founder of my two female empowerment courses. One is called Boundary Bootcamp and one is called Real Love Revolution. And I also have a book coming out in April of 2021 called Boundary Boss, The Essential Guide to Talk True, Be Seen, and Finally Live Free. Welcome to the show if you're new, and welcome back if you've been here a bunch of times before. I am always so happy to see you. I've gotten so many emails lately about codependency, which happens to be one of my favorite topics. So that is what we're talking about. This is seven ways to recognize that you might be in a codependent relationship. So we hear a lot in social media and in popular culture today where people are talking all the time about codependency, but I feel like there is a lot of misinformation out there and that there's a lot of confusion about what it really is. So I just figured I would give you seven simple ways to identify if you might be experiencing a codependent relationship right now. So the definition of codependency, there's a bunch of different ones. I say if you are overly invested in the feeling states, the decisions, the outcomes of the people you're in relationships with, that is codependency. So overly invested, as if what's happening to them or their decisions are happening to you or they are your decisions, which they're not if you're separate people, right? Melody Beattie, who is very well known. She's one of the premier people who writes about codependency. She wrote a book decades ago called Codependent No More, which really is like the seminal text on codependency, but codependency has also changed over the years. Her definition is, a codependent person is one who has let another person's behavior affect him or her and who's obsessed with controlling that person's behavior. Now, we all are affected in some way by the behaviors of the people we're in relationship with, but the obsession to control the other person is what really tips it over into codependent territory. And with codependency, a lot of times there is a lot of covert bidding for control. So let me just get through the seven ways that you can recognize if you're in a codependent relationship. And I've created a guide for you, some questions that you'll be able to ask yourself. And to get that guide, it's just go to terricole.com/263 and you can download it right there. So let's move into also clarification that codependency is not just in romantic relationships. And that's a lot of times people think that it's only if it's a romantic partner, but that is actually not true. It's in families, it's with siblings, it can be with friends. So already let's just start with that truth. So the first thing is that you have a tendency to always end up in a relationship with, I call it the broken winged bird syndrome, where it's someone who's very needy, someone whose life is a mess, someone who needs something. You also might end up in a relationship with people who are unavailable. So that can be, this is where codependency and addiction, there's always this, seems to be this connection, because that's a lot of what Melody Beattie wrote about in Codependent No More, was how these relationships happen when you're involved with an addict. But we've certainly expanded the definition over the decades since then. You don't have to be involved with an addict, but it does happen if the person's an alcoholic, drug addict, if there is domestic violence, if the person is a narcissist, if they're controlling, if they're super immature, irresponsible. So that is someone, if you're attracted to those people or you're in a relationship with someone like that right now, that's a sign. If you are overly dialed into your partner's feelings to the point that if they come home, you've had a great day, you feel happy, you're home, and they walk in and they've had a terrible day and they're in an awful mood, suddenly your good mood goes out the window and you're now, working as fast as possible to do something to change their mood, but you basically are taking on their mood. You're trying to fix what is happening with them because a desire to fix and control, because that is controlling, is a telltale sign of codependency. The third thing to look out for is having massive communication challenges within the relationship. If you are constantly feeling misunderstood, that is a sign that the relationship is probably codependent, where if what you say will be used against you later, if the person is misunderstanding what you're saying in a way that almost makes you feel crazy, like, did I say it wrong? Massive communication challenges are usually in with codependent relationships. And you might even be in a relationship, and if you say something that the person doesn't like, they may then stonewall you, which is just become silent, or withdraw their attention and affection from you. That's another sign. The fourth thing to look out for is needing their approval, getting your self-worth from the other person and how they feel about you and how they're acting towards you right now, like in the moment, rather than, you know, self-worth when you are psychologically healthy and feel good about yourself. That is an inside job, so that there's a certain level of consistency. In codependent relationships, your self-worth goes up and down with what it is that the other person, how they're relating to you. Let's see, what else did I want to say? Oh yeah, being overly self-sacrificing. This is really abandoning yourself because it's in service of what you think is best for the other person or what the other person wants. So that is really painful to do. And it's very enabling behavior, because a lot of times, if you're in a codependent relationship, you are doing things, helping your partner, but really at the expense of your mental and emotional and physical and or spiritual well-being. It could be any of those things where you're continuing to support even if what you're supporting is their dysfunction. So that could be covering up for someone. If you're in a relationship with someone who has an addiction issue and they don't go to work and you're covering up for them if their boss calls, those types of things. But also continuing to, if you're making the money and you're supporting the other person's habit, you know it's not the right thing to do, but you feel trapped in that pattern of doing it. Because enabling, as much as it looks like, we're sort of doing it out of love, you don't want the other person to get in trouble. You know, how can I had a client who had grown kids living at home, and she and her husband were moving to a smaller place, and she was like, well, how can I just kick them out on the street? She had two kids, and they were 24 and 26. And I was like, you could make a plan and give them a deadline, move to your smaller place, and have faith that if you were abducted by aliens, they would probably find a place to live. But when you're really codependent, you think it's all on you to fix all the problems and all the people's problems if you love them. And that moves us to the next one, is overgiving. So number six is overgiving. You know, having more of a one-sided relationship where one person gives significantly more than the other. So you know that you are bringing way more than the other person is to the relationship, but that's sort of the dynamic and that's what keeps it going. We could also describe that as over and under functioning, where you are over functioning, which, believe it or not, leads the other person to under function even more. And it's incredibly, incredibly frustrating. And the seventh indication that you might be in a codependent relationship is that you feel like you actually cannot live without this person, which in turn is why you don't leave. And it's an illusion, because, you know, we really do all come into this world alone and go out of this world alone. But you're so in it with the codependency and you're so enmeshed in the relationship that you can't visualize your life without it, even if the relationship is causing you a lot of pain. So I hope that these seven indications of codependent relationships, that this was helpful to you. I hope that you download the guide so you can answer some questions about your own romantic history and learn something, because you really do want to stop this cycle because it's incredibly exhausting. And healthy love means mutuality, means interdependence, means they're filling up your bucket and you're filling up their bucket. And you really, really do deserve that in your life. And I also, if you know you're codependent, I wanted to tell you that I created a course, because I'm so obsessed with codependency, and I partnered with a love expert friend of mine. His name is Mark Groves. You might know him on the internet as Create the Love. And we have created a course together called Crushing Codependency. So if you're interested in that, just download. You can just go to the download page, terricole.com/263, and the information will be there for you. Or you can just go to terricole.com/CC, and all the information about the course, which is starting in a week from now, will be right there for you. And maybe it'll be a good fit. I would love to see you in there. In the meantime, I hope this was helpful. If it was, please share it on your social media platforms. I hope you guys have an amazing week. And as always, take care of you.